Hi, I'm Erika, one of the senior curriculum managers here at Magoosh and a GMAT expert. If you've watched my video on the 6 hardest GMAT math problems, you know that work rate is one of the word problems concepts that a lot of test takers really struggle with. In this video, we're going to walk through the 2 equations you need to know to solve work rate problems, and then we're going to work through a particularly nasty example problem. Let's jump in. Now, if you haven't seen Callie's video on distance problems on the GMAT, I really recommend checking that out because work rate builds on distance rate questions. But if you have, then you know the equation distance equals rate times time, or D equals RT, sometimes known as DIRT. The first work rate equation is actually very, very similar to that. It's going to be work equals rate times time, or W equals RT, or WERT. So with this equation, if we have any 2 of the variables, we can solve for the third. So if we have rate and time, we can solve for work. If we have work and rate, we can solve for time. And if we have work and time, we can solve for rate. So as an example, if we have a printer that prints 1 page every 2 seconds and we want to find its rate, the work is 1 page, the time is 2 seconds. Rearranging that, we get that rate is 1/2, or 1 page per 2 seconds. Relatively simple application. As a second example, if we have another printer that prints 1 page every 3 seconds, what is its rate? Here, work is 1 page, time is 3 seconds. Plugging that in, we get that the rate is 1/3, or 1 page per 3 seconds. Now, the second equation we need to know for work rate is the combined rate equation. And that's basically the idea that if we are looking for the rate of 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 things working together, all we need to do is add up the rate of each of those things working on their own. So, as an example, if we have our 2 printers, the one that prints 1 page every 2 seconds and the one that prints 1 page every 3 seconds, and we want to find their rate working together, we'll add up those 2 rates that we already solved for. So the rate of the first printer is 1 page every 2 seconds, or 1/2. The rate of the second printer is 1 page every 3 seconds, or 1/3. So we have 1/2 plus 1/3 equals our combined rate of the 2 printers. So finding a common denominator, we get 3/6 plus 2/6 equals 5/6. So we know that those printers working together are going to print 5 pages every 6 seconds. So let's put this all together in a GMAT style work rate problem. So in this problem, we have our 2 printers. We know that they start printing at the same time, and we want to know how long it will take them to print a 2,000 page manuscript. Okay, so the first thing we would do is use our work rate equation to solve for the individual rates of each printer, so 1/2 and 1/3. Then we're going to use our combined rate equation to solve for their rate working together, so that's 1/2 plus 1/3 equals 5/6. And then we're going to go back to our work rate equation in order to solve for the time given the work using our combined rate. So our work is 2,000 pages, our combined rate is 5/6. Plugging that in, we get 2,000 equals 5/6 times T. Rearranging, we're able to solve for the fact that time is going to be 2,400 seconds, which reduces to 40 minutes. And that's GMAT work rate problems in a nutshell. Now, if you know that you struggle with word problems in general, I really recommend subscribing to our channel and coming back next week because we got a video on overlapping sets word problems coming out soon. So that would be an example of a relatively easy work rate problem. Let's go ahead and try a particularly hard one from Magoosh. Okay, so in this problem, we have a really classic work rate scenario. We've got 2 pumps that are emptying a pool. Now, even though this is a pretty classic scenario, there are a couple of things that make this problem complicated. Let's work through those. So starting with the first sentence, pump A can empty a pool in A minutes, and pump B can empty the same pool in B minutes. So notice that they're giving us variables instead of numbers, and we can see that in our answer choices as well. This is a classic move for pretty much any type of word problem to make it more complicated and to force us to do algebra instead of arithmetic. So that is one thing. We're going to deal with that in a second. Second sentence, pump A begins emptying the pool for 1 minute before pump B joins. Okay, so this is something that's specific to rate problems, and basically what's happening here is we're splitting up our process of emptying the pool into 2 phases with 2 different rates. So in this first phase, we've got A working alone, that's going to have the rate of just A, and then in the second phase, we've got A and B working together, so that's going to be one of those combined rates. Okay, interesting. Finally, last sentence, beginning from the time pump A starts, how many minutes will it take to empty the pool? So we are looking for the total time. Okay, so the first thing that I'm gonna do is deal with the variables. And the way I'm gonna handle that is the way that we often handle it with word problems, which is picking my own numbers. So instead of working with A and B, I'm gonna pick numbers that I think will be easy to work with, that I can do the problem with, solve for an answer in terms of those numbers, and then put the answer choices in terms of those numbers as well and see which one matches. So I'm gonna pick numbers here. I'm going to pick A equals 3. And B equals 4. You can pick other numbers. Those are just the ones that I chose. Okay, so that eliminates an element of complexity. I'm gonna work with those numbers as I solve. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come up with my various rates. So I know work equals rate times time. That can be rearranged to rate equals work over time. Okay, using that information, I'm gonna solve for each of my rates. So the rate of A, I know that pump A can empty one pool in A minutes, so my work is one pool, and my time will be A. I have chosen that A is 3. So the rate of A is 1/3. Great. The rate of B, I'm going to solve for in a similar way. B empties one pool in B minutes. B is 4. 1/4. Okay, let's deal with combined rate. Now, I know that combined rate, the rate of A and B, is going to be the rate of A plus the rate of B. Okay, rate of A is 1/3, rate of B is 1/4. Adding that up, I would find a common denominator, but I'm just gonna tell you that it ends up being 7/12. Awesome. Okay, using that information, I'm gonna start working through my phases. Now, something that I really like to do, just gonna circle this, is to make a little work rate table. And the way that I do that is setting up my little work equals rate times time equation and using that to make columns. And then I make a row for each of the phases of my work rate problem. So my first phase is A working alone. And then my second phase is A and B working together. Okay, great. So what do I know? Well, I know the rates for each of those phases. So I know that the rate for just A working alone is 1/3. And I know that the rate for A and B working together is 7/12. Awesome. I also know from the problem that pump A in its phase works alone for 1 minute. So that's my time for this row. Okay, now at this point, I'm starting to see that I have something I can solve for, which is the work for A alone. So I know work equals rate times time. So because I have rate and time, I can solve for work. So I'm gonna come up with the fact that my work is 1/3 because 1/3 equals 1/3 times 1. Great, okay. Now I can extrapolate a little bit more information. So I go, okay, I know that A alone does 1/3 of the work. Well, I know that we are going to empty the pool, right? That is what I'm solving for. How much time will it take to empty the pool? So that means that I'm going to finish the whole pool's worth of work over these two phases. So if I've got 1/3 done already, that must mean that A and B together do the other 2/3 of the work. And once again, I see that I have this W equals RT equation in the second row now, where I have two of the pieces. So now I can solve for the third. So I know 2/3 equals 7/12 times something. Now at this point, what I would do is I would write this out as a separate equation with a variable in for t and then isolate for t in order to solve. But in the interest of time and saving space on the whiteboard, when you do that, you end up with 8/7 as the time for A and B. And if we just want to check that right now, we can see that if we multiplied rate and time here, the sevens would cancel. We would get 8/12, which reduces to 2/3. Okay, now that's not our answer because we know that here we're solving for our total time. So that means I'm going to be adding up my times for each phase. So I've got 1 + 8/7 or 7/7 plus 8/7, which gives me 15/7. Okay, so that means when I take my values for A and B, 3 and 4, and plug them into these answer choices, the correct answer should give me 15 over 7. All right, so taking a look at my answer choices right away, I'm going to go ahead and say I'm pretty sure it's not A because that's over 2. How am I going to get that to be 15 over 7? Unlikely. Now, taking a look at the other answer choices, I see that the denominator is A plus B or 3 plus 4, which will be 7. So all of those are looking equally likely. I'm going to go ahead and start with my easiest one, which is C. So here I've got 3 plus 4 in the denominator. So that's 7. And A times B, or 3 times 4, which is 12 in the numerator. Okay, so that is too small. And that's a really useful piece of information, because if I take a look at D and E, I see that those are subtracting something. So those are going to be even smaller than 12 over 7, definitely not going to be 15 over 7, which leaves me with B as my only answer. I'm just going to go ahead and check and confirm that. So again, my denominator is going to be 7, or 3 plus 4. My numerator is going to be 3 times 5, or 4 plus 1, which is going to be 15. Nice. So my correct answer here is B. So this problem represents a particularly complex application of our work rate equations. However, it really just is those two equations. And if we're able to stay organized and take advantage of some tricks and some very neat organization, we can get through it in a reasonable amount of time. Let us know if this video helped you by liking and subscribe to our channel for more videos from me and the other experts at Magoosh. And as always, if you have any comments or questions or suggestions, leave those in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you soon.